in my bones. So good, I never felt this strong. And I can't hold it in no more. The truth will set me free, I'm sure. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I would. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I would. You got me feeling so good.
One night a year, WWE goes extreme.
If you're not excited right now, you better check your pulse.
I want the Raw Women's title in a ladder match. Consider the ante up.
Edge is gone, not coming back.
Oh my God,
Edge is back!
For the first time ever, Edge versus Finn Balor in an I Quit match.
Welcome to WWE's The Buff.
What else is gonna happen on The Buff?
I'm kind of a fan of the reckless nature.
Yes. I can't. All right, love you, brother.
There's really no limitations to what you can do with an RKO.
Raquel needs to, all caps, destroy Sonya Deville.
I agree in all caps that.
The WWE fandom is incredible. Love me, hate me, I don't care.
I miss looking forward to wrestling every week.
This is the most competitive environment.
I love this more than I've loved anything in my whole entire life.
We have so much talent in WWE.
You can bet on me.
Look at that face. I love when he's happy.
Not even Kayla can ruin my mood today.
Follow your dream.
That Undertaker character really served me well.
I've watched The Buff many times. Y'all all do your homework.
It's a lot of fun.
We got the good life.
World famous wrestling show, The Buff!
feel the power. And I present to you my brother, my partner, oh, the man is so pretty, Tyler Breeze. And last but certainly not least, back from a long sabbatical, I give to you the one, the only, Kayla Braxton!
Big E! That's how you introduce some yes. people. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm very excited to have both of you here. It's so good to be back here in the Bump Studio for the first time in a month. There's nobody I would have rather to introduce me as you. So thank you so much for
thank
that.
You, thank you. Thank you.
All right, now you gotta recharge, get some water. We're gonna see you here in the studio in just a little bit, so you guys hang tight for the rest of you. Like I said, so excited to be back here in Stamford, Connecticut. We have got one fun show ahead. Let's see if I can get through this door, because I haven't opened it in a while. It's time for the bump! It's heavier. Woo!
Hey, you're back!
Good job, Kayla.
Wow.
I specifically told you to fix the door before I got back. Boy. I wanted to come back and it be extra light. Now it's extra heavy. What's
You've
up?
Been lifting.
It's my job.
That's your job.
It's my job to fix the door.
Hello,
hey, you're back.
Hey, Kayla.
Yay.
I am so happy to be back here. I have missed both of you, dear. No, I've missed
Wow,
you
that could not have been a faker.
And it's perfect timing because, of course, it's a few days away from Extreme Rules. We're going to be in Philadelphia. I'm going to get me some Philly cheesesteaks. And as always, for every premium live event, we will be there on the ground for a special bump episode. Of course, Ryan will be holding the fort down here in Stamford, Connecticut. And also, before we move on, I just want to say that we just celebrated 3 years of WWE's The Bump. We appreciate Great. All of you so much for tuning in, supporting us, interacting with us. And guys, 3 years down, like 100 more to go at least, so.
You got some new science I don't know about? 3 years, and I believe we're like 13 episodes away from 200 on top of that as well. Yeah, December?
That's right. And of course, Ryan, you're always checking out what people at home, people on their social media websites are talking about.
Yeah, all those social websites. They're talking
how old
about
did how you get when you were gone?
About how we're going to be 130 plus hosting The Bump, which is going to be a great time. Scott and the YouTube chat says hi. Fabian loved Big E's intro. Everyone's happy Kayla's back, including me and Matt, especially me and Matt. And we want you guys to get in on every facet of today's show with questions, comments, using hashtag WWETheBump in the YouTube chat, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all the, to quote Kayla, social media websites. So much to talk about. Let's dive in. Let's get it.
That's right. Thank you so much, Ryan. And before we do get into today's show and talking about who is going to be here, we do want to invite all of you to join WWE in supporting the American Red Cross and their relief efforts for those impacted by Hurricane Ian. Text the word Ian to 90999 to donate today. And, you know, guys, I lived in Florida for a long time. I have a lot of friends who were affected, who are now having to, unfortunately, deal with the damage that was done to their homes and their properties. So I know that this will also really mean a lot to them and, you know, mean a lot to me as someone who loves Florida. And it's such a near and dear place in my heart. So, again, donate if you still feel compelled.
Absolutely. And I know, you know, everybody's want to watch and things go down, and hopefully we can be a distraction for some of these people that are going through things. I was just in Orlando yesterday and seeing what people are kind of coming back from, everybody thinking about you, but hopefully we can provide some distraction and some help and some entertainment, because that's what we do. And of course, now we lead you into what's going on this week. Season premiere is coming your way on SmackDown Extreme Rules, but let's talk about Monday Night Raw, because there were some statements made on Monday Night Raw. And I am talking about Damage Control. Candice LeRae in her second match on Monday Night Raw taking on Dakota Kai. A lot of history there. And as we have been seeing since SummerSlam, Bayley has to get involved. She would give a little help to Dakota Kai, and Dakota would become victorious. Then we had the contract signing for the ladder match for the Raw Women's Championship. And Bayley said, hey, I'll come out by myself, no problem. Of course, what was going on in the back, we saw Asuka and Alexa Bliss get taken out, but they couldn't take Alexa out all the way, so she would challenge Io in the main event, and this is what it devolved into. Because Asuka was taken out earlier, the numbers game, as always, in the favor of Damage Control. They would take out Bianca there. The Genius of the Sky with that beautiful and devastating moonsault would give Io the victory, but that would not be the end of the night because they would continue to lay out. Asuka would come back out, Bianca Belair, and of course Alexa Bliss. And that is the image that Bayley wants to leave everybody with, not only this past Monday on Raw, but that is what she wants to be the future and the reality come Extreme Rules when it comes to the Raw Women's Championship.
By the way, first time I've been back in studio since they decided to come here and take over. Yeah. I appreciate your no help in that, by the way.
What did I do?
What didn't you do?
What would you like me to do? Those three women are very dangerous. They have 45 years of experience. And Dakota Kai, and luckily not Bayley, had a kendo stick sitting right next to me. So I was playing it very nice.
Fine. Ryan, what's the people online saying?
Well, Bayley had ample to say after Monday night. She said a lot on Monday night. She said a lot to Bianca. She said a lot to the WWE Universe. Let's start with what she said to Bianca after the fact. Because after that massive beatdown on Monday night, Bayley posted this pic and especially directed this towards Bianca, said snatched in all caps. But that is not all Bayley said, because Bayley went after everybody on Monday. Izzy, former long famous Bayley fan, said, I feel personally attacked by Bayley's comments on Monday night about little girls wearing headbands. Well, Bayley replied to Izzy saying, you're the worst. But that was not all, because Bayley also said that there should be more Bayley signs at Raw and, you know, premium live events. So Courtney here said, why, I have a sign. I was at Raw, I have a sign. And in maybe the tweet of the year, Bayley said, you think anyone's gonna see that tiny ass sign? And man, did I howl.
So
and I've read it 5,000 times and howled all 5,000 times. Bayley not pleased with the WWE Universe. She's not pleased with Bianca Belair. However, this Saturday at Extreme Rules, Bayley has a chance to back up everything she has said this past Monday, everything she has said since Damage Control has formed and become Raw Women's Champion in a historic ladder match. So much on the line, obviously the Raw Women's title, but also a lot of respect here between the two that is long, long gone. We will see what happens this Saturday night. Kayla.
All right, and like we said earlier, this Friday night is the SmackDown season premiere. Things continue to heat up every single week, by the way. I want to shout out to wearing my honorary Usher.
I got more questions about that one.
let's run through what happened this past Friday night, Matt.
Yeah, let's talk about it because you see it there. We know it's going down in Extreme Rules. It's a strap match in Philadelphia. Drew McIntyre and Karrion Kross. And we know Drew was the one who kind of set this up because he's tired of getting attacked from behind. Well, you can't go anywhere when you're attached by a 12-foot leather strap. That brings us to last Friday because, well, we have seen Austin Theory run a little bit here with Alpha Academy, and he was running his mouth, and of course, Drew was right there, and he said, oh, you want to run your mouth? Let's go to the ring and do it. Alpha Academy would get involved. However, look who else got involved, making an appearance on SmackDown. Kevin Owens and Johnny Gargano, official friends of the show. Kayla, you weren't here for that one. But these three men would find some common ground. So if you're going to find common ground, what better way to handle that? You take it into the ring, and that was the main event of SmackDown. We saw Alpha Academy, Austin Theory taking on KO, Johnny Gargano, and Drew McIntyre. Ooh. And look at that, Claymore, Austin
that
Theory, you're a town down. And Drew McIntyre would be victorious at the end of SmackDown, and he would send a strong message not only to Theory, but of course to Karrion Kross as well. This is your future, Mr. Kross. Now his focus is on Kross. He's got to put the championship aspirations behind him for now, but Drew sending a very strong statement, and a strap match is as vicious as it gets, especially in Philadelphia.
And Drew's no one to mess around with. You know, he saw me talking to Theory before his match with Drew this past Friday, talking smack
like
as he always
too.
Does. But Drew means business, so Kross, you better watch out. Ryan.
I 100% agree. Drew McIntyre made a massive statement on Friday night. Karrion Kross heard that statement and responded in due kind with this tweet saying, suffering is a catalyst for change. He saw what Drew did. He is not bothered heading into Saturday night. Let's talk about good vibes, though, because strap matches are vicious. Johnny Gargano was glad to reunite with Drew McIntyre on Friday. In turn, Drew McIntyre was glad to reunite with Johnny Gargano and Kevin Owens on Friday night. With all of that in mind, everyone loved the trio of these three together. WWE on Fox asked us to name this trio, to which I saw this one and I thought it was great. Mian here says, God mode, Gargano, Owens, Drew. That's a bit of a statement to Roman, but first and foremost, Drew McIntyre. He made the statement last Friday. He now puts it on the line. And as vicious a match as it comes, a strap match this Saturday, Extreme Rules against Karrion Kross. If you want physical and hard hitting, that's this, Kayla. Let's go.
All right, guys, like I said earlier, we want to remind everyone that this Saturday, Extreme Rules in Philadelphia, we will be there live, Matt and I, to break down everything that we can expect. The special WWE's The Bump will be presented by NetSpend. And, of course, again, we have previews, live interviews. It's always a really good time. We can be on the ground on our premium live event days. But we also want to remind everyone that we'll be doing our monthly DraftKings breakdown with Ryan and Matt live to give you the best advice possible for your free pool. So, Matt, what else can you tell us about that?
Well, let's talk about that right now because we are doing our DraftKings pool. And, of course, we have our segment, which has a little bit of a curveball, as this month we will be doing a prediction pool this time around. And I'll explain more about that in a second. Just a reminder, you can download or go to the DraftKings Sportsbook app, make your picks, and you have a chance to win $10,000 on free DraftKings free WWE 10K prediction pool. We want to remind everyone to use the code BUMP when they sign up. And before we move on through, Ryan and I are going to discuss one of the questions in our pool and debate it before we bring on our first guest. Ryan, let's talk about this question. Oof. This is what you're going to see in this. Who should be the next WWE Universal Champion? Cody Rhodes, Seth freaking Rollins, or Drew McIntyre?
We were talking about this earlier. It's a bit of a heart versus head situation here. I personally, Seth freaking Rollins is building momentum day over day, month over month. Let's see what happens this Saturday in the fight pit at Extreme Rules. But me personally, Roman Reigns versus Seth freaking Rollins really sings to me. That's where I'm at.
That's what I believe, of course, Seth freaking Rollins thinks as well. But you guys can go, of course, check that out and vote on it. And we'll be talking all about that this Saturday as part of our DraftKings segment for Extreme Rules Saturday, 3 p.m. Eastern, as part of that episode of WWE's The Bump, Kayla.
All right, guys. Well, now it is about that time to feel the power of two men that we have the most admiration for. Our first guests are truly two of the most beloved superstars in the last decade here in WWE, and they also happen to be some pretty close friends. Tomorrow at the Nerds booth at New York Comic Con, there will be a limited edition Up Up Down Down shirt only in New York, and these two gentlemen will be doing a signing at 1 p.m. Eastern at that time. But first, they've stopped here in Stamford, Connecticut at the WWE's The Bump Studio. Please welcome to the show Big E and Tyler Breeze.
Yeah, we're here. Yeah. We're here. It's tight. We're going to make it. We're going to do it. Yeah, I got it. I got my boy. He's back.
Get your hands off me.
I want to be carried into the studio like that from now on.
Got you next time.
Thank you. Beautiful. Welcome to the
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Yes.
Welcome.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
Good to see you, buddy. Jordan's over. Oh, look at that.
Feels good.
That is so much love.
She's good. Easy.
Just something I mean, it's love in the club over here. Club bump.
Dude, it's beautiful.
Hello.
Oh, no, he said, we coming in here?
Uh-oh.
This is what happens.
It's a mess already.
This is what happens.
Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
This is
you
what happens.
Now, it's okay. It's okay.
We don't need to hear anything.
We're just going
to
wing it.
That always goes well.
Sometime magically in the next 45 minutes, that might get fixed. But yeah. Hey, good to have you guys here.
Good to be here. Yeah.
Well, listen, welcome both of you back to the show. We do want to tell everyone that this segment of The Bump is presented by the WWE NetSpend prepaid MasterCard. Scan the QR code on the screen now to order your card and carry your favorite WWE superstars in your wallet. And look, we have a sneak peek at these cards right here. Are they preloaded? Can I go shopping after this? We're going to get to more about NetSpend in a little bit. But before that, let's get into the interview with you guys first. So, Big E, we're going to hop all around. Lots we want to talk to you about. But first and foremost, everyone wants to know, how you feeling, bud?
I feel great. I feel great. It is good to be missed. No, I feel really good, man. For everyone, I know sometimes when I'm out in public, people are very dainty with me, but I'm good. I feel great. Things have been tremendous for me, so it's a blessing. I'm good.
And Breeze, it's been a while since we've had you here on The Bump. How does it feel to be on a one-match winning streak? Matt wrote that.
You are.
I'm on a one-match winning streak?
You're on a one-match winning streak.
What is my one match?
You guys beat Imperium last time I took you out of match.
There you go.
You didn't know that?
Hey, man. That was what? Like,
you got a W1 next to your name in the standings.
I'm okay with it. So now that it's come to my attention, I feel pretty good.
There you go.
I feel pretty good.
I'm glad I revealed that to you. You got a lot of stuff going on.
Somebody's keeping track.
Your video games and investments, but W1 next to your name. So it's going well.
I like that.
We have the Creeds coming up a little bit. I want to talk a little NIL with you guys. But you were on your school. You have Flatbacks in Florida. As someone who trained with Lance Storm, if I could be serious for a moment.
Sure.
Now that you're in a similar spot, how do you look at athletes? He did this when he came up through FCW. We're going to talk to the Creeds. There's a lot of that going on. Athletes who have never stepped foot in a ring before, how do you handle them versus maybe some that have stepped in a ring before?
Well, so this is crazy. So there's kind of a couple ways you can look at it. One of them is you have to take what we do and you have to kind of give it the credit it deserves. So, for example, I could, if I hop on a football field, I could probably throw a ball, right? I might not be the best, but I could probably do it. If I hop on a basketball court, I could probably sink a couple, but maybe not. But if I grabbed LeBron James and Tom Brady and I toss them in a wrestling ring, they might struggle with what we do because it's so different. So having an athletic background, being an athlete is great.
You need this too, right,
and
though?
Can
you
help
need this
you.
Too, though.
But that is what it needs. Yeah, you need the personality. You need the emotion, that what we do requires. So being an athlete, obviously, very, very important. But we need the emotion.
A lot more to it. You've been in this world for about 15 years now, if I'm correct.
Yeah.
I think somewhere in that realm. What are you telling your students now or anybody that's thinking about getting into this that you would have wanted to know 15 years ago?
Oh, man, that's tough. That's tough. I got to say, you got to prepare. You got to prepare. You got to be ready. Because, again, this is probably, if this is what you're looking to do, it's going to be one of the hardest things that you're ever going to do. So everything you can do to prepare and start thinking about the shirt that you want people to buy, but why should they buy that shirt?
Sure.
You need to have the substance to it. Otherwise, you're just, among the thousands of people who want to do this.
Look at that.
That right there.
That. There's a lot in that right there.
See?
There's an entire beautiful episode of Feel the Power that explains why you're basically the fourth member, the honorary member of the New Day. But why are you so close? Why do you love E so much? We all love E so much. No, everyone loves E so much.
What's your connection?
What's your connection to this guy?
Honestly, you know what? I mean, if you guys know me, I'm kind of a goof. So
no.
Anything that's like funny or whatever just immediately gets me. And any time that he's in the room or any time that we start doing anything, I just start laughing immediately, which most of the time everybody else does too.
You light up a room.
That's right. That's exactly right. So how can you not laugh when he's around?
So I have to ask. I'm going to go the other way. You have an 0-1 record against E. Why does he have your number in the ring?
Wow. Well, I mean, I can actually attribute it to a couple things. So E was, when we were wrestling together, he was a big backstage politics guy. And we wrestled around the world, actually, and all of a sudden, I was taken out of that match. Don't know why, but then all of a sudden, I was taken off of SmackDown, and then all of a sudden, I was back on NXT, and then all of a sudden, I was out of NXT, and I attribute that all to him and his backstage politics.
He does this all the time.
Well, it's true. I mean, prove me wrong.
The problem is I don't have the evidence.
Say those things.
Prove
they
me
never
wrong.
Happen.
Right. I mean, prove yes, me but I don't have evidence. But this is a lie he likes to commonly tell. But no, we've been close for a while. And I don't even know when it started.
Despite the politics.
Yeah. But no. We've been tight.
Probably FCW.
FCW, yeah. We go way back. That's right.
And now you're here. Thank you for that.
Of course.
And sharing your friendship.
Start at the bottom, and now we're here.
Oh, there we go.
Now you're on the bump. Before we get into more, what's all the more up, down stuff coming up here? Let's talk about what's going on at Comic-Con tomorrow with the two of you. As we mentioned earlier, tomorrow at the Nerds booth at New York Comic-Con, there will be a limited edition. There it is right there. Up, down shirt only in New York. And you'll be doing a signing at 1 p.m. Eastern. You're here with your buddy. You're going to be there at Woods?
Yes. Yeah. I often question why anyone would want to see me or have me scribble on anything. I don't really understand it, but I thank you. It means a lot to me, and I enjoy these signings. So we'll be there at New York Comic Con. I've never done New York Comic Con, so it'll be my first one. It'll be a blast. But yeah, to do it with the up, down team, to get to do these things with your friends, it's the very best. Mm-hmm. So we're excited to be there. We'll be scribbling on things. Again, I don't really get why. I don't get the appeal. But we'll be there with our smiling faces.
If they bring a piece of asparagus, we'll sign it.
Asparagus.
That's
a tough thing to sign.
Well, I mean, we'll do it, though. You know what I mean?
I want one of those.
What are you doing?
Breeze, are you looking forward to visiting anything while you're at Comic-Con?
So actually, have we done a signing before together?
No.
I feel like we never have.
Oh! No.
I've done a couple with Woods, and so, you know, we kind of, you know, the relationship, the chemistry there, obviously. But adding you to the mix is going to be great. And so we actually did New York Comic Con last year.
Right.
And it was a little different. But this year, I guess, it's kind of back up and running, doing its thing. So there's always a million things to explore. So as soon as we're done our signing, I think, like, we're going out and exploring everything. So there's a ton of people. I actually haven't looked at the lineup of, like, everybody who's going to be there. But it's kind of fun just
kind of
to
fun surprise.
Explore. Yeah, yeah. I like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Also, before I forget, this is random, but I need some thoughts on my uncle fit. I don't know if this is... I'm trying something out.
Love it.
The turtleneck and hat, it works?
Yes. Uncle? 10 out of 10.
Uncle? I think an uncle.
Do you
right.
remember the Chappelle sketch with Wack Arnold's? Like, the guy was like... what do you say?
The fake McDonald's one.
Yes, but there was the guy said he was happy about the job, and he was... Calvin's got a like. That's not you look. I
gotta rewatch that.
But it's a good look.
Is that okay?
It's yes.
A good look.
No, it's.
You don't have to bring an iron or anything with
that's
you.
That's right. No iron.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. That
is and it's turtleneck season, so that's good too.
Yes.
Great color blocking.
Thank you,
Breeze. A lot of people rightly bring up your former tag team partner, Roman Reigns' unbelievable championship run over the last 2 years, but he's not here today.
Yeah.
You are, and no one has ever defended the up, up, down, down championship more than you successfully. 7 title defenses.
Wow.
Should you be the first ever inductee into a non-existent, but should exist, up, up, down, down Hall of Fame? And how do you get back championship gold or colors on up, up, down, down?
I mean, I would assume, you know, I mean, if you look at me and Roman's kind of career paths, they're very similar. You know what I mean? They're very
former
similar.
Former FCW tag team
that's
champions.
Right. That's right. That's why they paired us together. Right. So. I think if there's a Hall of Fame and when there's a Hall of Fame, I have to be number one. If not, like, what's the point then?
I agree. And by the way, this was the Up, Up, Down, Down studio. It's not anymore.
You overtook it.
It's wow. not anymore. But here's what I would say. I offer to raise Michael Cole's orange singlet to the rafters. I think we should do that for you.
Please.
As part of, like, the Up, Up, Down, Down.
Wait, what are you raising to the rafters?
It's your choice. It's like the bust You're, for
no,
the baseball.
It sounded like you had an
okay.
idea.
I will throw this out to everybody watching, Up, Up, Down, Down fans. What would you raise to the rafters for Tyler? Would it be a selfie stick or is it up, up, down, down stuff? Is it a controller?
Left, right, title.
We're going to get to that up in a little bit. Option. So I want to know, Ryan, keep an eye on social. I want to see what the people
Matt,
say.
I'm going to see your call to action there. We want thoughts on that. I'm going to raise you another because off of what Big E just said, hashtag Big E Uncle Fit. We want your thoughts.
I'd like to know.
I will monitor this through the rest of the hour. So let's do that. So 2 call to actions. Please let us know. Big E, I'm going to direct this back to you. Let's switch gears for a hot second.
Okay.
Because you're talking about how you're surprised that people want you to scribble on anything. Mm-hmm. With that in mind, let's take a look at this video real quick.
Surprising our son with a wrestler that looks like him.
No peeking. Close your eyes.
Don't peek. Hold it right there. Go.
Oh, Big E.
Yeah.
You're the baby mugging Macho Man.
I get Big E and you get Macho Man?
Yeah.
All right, Big E, what do you think?
Good.
Good. Put. Okay, out of all the wrestlers here,
yeah.
Which one do you think you look the most like? Big E?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Big E's the best.
Because of what?
And the best.
He's the best.
The best?
Yeah.
Why do you think he's the best?
He's the best.
He's got muscles like you?
Yeah.
Yeah? Does he have a haircut like yours?
Yeah.
Yeah? He's pretty awesome, isn't he?
Gotta fight that.
Okay, let's make a bite.
W-E, mink grease.
Oh my gosh, how sweet!
That's too adorable.
That's meaningful no matter what, but especially now you're away from the ring and you're still able to have that impact on a little kid. What does that mean?
Man, when I saw that video for the first time, it's really just one of the most heartwarming things. Especially as I've gotten older as a performer, it means so much to me to be a part of people's childhoods and just to be a part of a bonding moment between a father and a son or a daughter and a mom, you know, just any of those things really, really warms my heart. So it's incredible. It really is incredible to have that kind of an impact on anyone. I grew up with my wrestling figures, you know, and I'll always remember my Hacksaw Jim Duggan and my Jake the Snake and, you know, just the moments playing in my old ring. So those moments are truly incredible, and it really, really was just the sweetest thing to see.
Aww. That's awesome. I hope that kid gets a chance to have you scribble on his action figure.
That I'd have no problem with. Yes.
It got Dusty in here a little bit with us watching that. Speaking of Dusty, speaking of emotional, you, like me, unabashed This Is Us super fan. What'd you make of the finale, and what does life now look like for you and I without it?
Man, it hurts. It hurts. I can't believe that all these shows are getting, they're getting some kind of a reunion. They're getting spin-offs. I couldn't believe there was no spin-off. I need to know what the Pearsons are doing with their lives, man.
Months.
I said the same thing. They need to be like a movie now, like a movie that kind of wraps it up.
You could be an uncle, maybe, perhaps. I feel like this is a role that you should play.
Uncle Fit.
I'm here for it. I'm here for it. But that show is incredible. For people who don't know, I love that show so much that I actually feel like the last three seasons, I would take notes.
Oh, wow.
And I have a friend, Marissa, in California, and we would watch it on FaceTime together, and we would discuss during the commercial breaks. That's how much I love the show. It didn't fall off at all. The consistency was incredible. Man, that last season was it was beautiful.
I was watching them like on the plane when I was like crying my eyes out. Whoever's sitting next to me, I think, thought something was drastically wrong in my life because I just couldn't keep it together. I've never been so emotional on a show in my life.
The Pierce, I honestly, it's bizarre. I know they're TV characters, but I feel this kinship with those people.
It's good television.
Yes, it is. It really is.
Agreed. All right, now, E, you also recently revealed that you're joining the talk. The TikTok is what I mean by
that. Oh, all right. The talk, like the show that's on TV? I was in a... With the ladies? Like, I don't know if I'm on the top.
I would watch that.
All right.
I'm a big TikTok fan. I wake up every day, start my morning with a healthy amount of TikTok videos. Do you know what your account would look like?
I really have no idea. Honestly, I got on it to shill, to make money. Mm. I got that's really, if I'm being honest.
No shit.
I have one video. It's from Wendy's deal that I did. Because, you know, shout out to Wendy's for one. I might as well use this moment to shill as well.
Go.
But anyways, they have a Biggie bag.
I know. I'm so excited.
I'm
well overdue.
I used to work at Wendy's when I was 17 years old. I was out here making them doubles and triples and junior bacons for the people of North Tampa and that community. So that, I would love to do that. So that's pretty much why I'm on TikTok. And I'll probably also be sitting at home while I recover. Mm. And I'll probably get bored and I might do some nonsense as well. But it's really mostly to get these ducats. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The greenbacks.
Yeah.
The Gouda.
Make it rain.
Yeah, the cheese. That's why I'm on it. Yeah.
The cheddar.
I'm not proud of myself. That's why I am.
That's been cars at Wendy's, of course.
You can, yes.
Right? Does that work?
I think it should.
Also, Wendy Chu thought she could maybe get involved, so I think there's
I understand.
Oh, but, there was a tone there.
Right, but
Chu Crew,
Wendy,
come on now.
I mean, fan of what you're doing, but fall back.
No!
The Wendy's dollars, they're mine. They belong to me, Wendy.
Could she do the kids' meal?
I mean,
I feel like that makes sense.
Yeah, okay, all right, you're right, you're right.
There,
there's,
for
room, there's room for
Come
others.
On now.
Right, right, right. But let me get mine first.
It's the runoff.
A lot is happening. Real quick, Breeze, I have a question for you, but real quick, we have Big E Uncle Fit hashtag news, but we'll get to that in a second. Okay. Breeze, I'll kick this to you first. What do you think? Who do you think is the best trash talker in Up, Up, Down, Down history? We have E here. Kofi's going to come up. Breeze, I direct this to you.
Who do I think?
Yes.
Oh, me, 100%.
I agree with that. I do agree with that, actually.
I'll tell you, if something happens, if I win, which most of the time I do, then I just black out and things start happening. I've done some of my best work after a title defense. And all of a sudden, like 10 minutes later, I'm still going. Couldn't tell you what I said, but it is good.
I'll give him that.
It is good. You've heard it. You've seen it live in action. It is good.
Well, you know, speaking of trash talkers, we know that when the two of you have been on Up, Up, Down, that down, there's been a lot of fun to take place. Let's just watch this real quick.
God!
Freeze! Hit
him!
Go, 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 E, go!
No! God!
Son of a bitch! Come make me laugh!
Stop him! Stop him! Stop him!
Who are you yelling at to stop me?
I said stop, I said stab.
Oh, it's just you.
Stab him.
You were yelling at you to stab me?
Yes.
Didn't listen.
We're playing Wheel of Fortune. We got Big Bull.
Yeah!
I want the three of us to be able to do a full split
in all directions.
No, that was like that was the I did and I took it back.
Wait, like you guys break up?
No, like
you know me?
You said split. No.
Kick his. How dare you?
Yeah, all three of you go in different directions.
No, you idiot.
God.
It's do the splits, man.
No.
I think my controller bird.
I don't know if that's it.
When you watch these episodes, please tweet at Pat Sajak and tell him you need us on the show.
Oh! Ouch. Make money!
Let's go!
I feel like you're too energized for Wheel. No, I feel like great. Sajak would be like, dude, calm down.
My God!
Hit triangle, you doofus!
Yeah, go ahead and saw.
Oh, what?
Yeah. I told you.
No.
Savant.
I grew up watching Wheel.
He's a secret Wheel master. A Wheel hustler.
Every day, at any time, Wheel and Jeopardy.
Jeez.
Why does that happen?
Like, yeah, what is it about that brings up that unfiltered aspect of y'all's relationship that obviously we're also seeing it on the show here today? What is it about y'all's relationship that can bring that out?
Remember what you were asking about why we get along and why I want to be around him? That's why, yeah. Because when it happens, he's just a loose cannon.
He's like, how dare you?
I don't know what that in your
Brian flight. Pillman and Big E yeah, are the loose cannons.
You're freaking out. I'm laughing because everything you do makes me laugh.
But, were you eating asparagus in the beginning of that? Was that where that joke came from? You were eating some kind of green vegetable.
I was eating asparagus in that one video.
And I was not. I was on a trolley earlier there.
Just call back to the asparagus comment you made earlier. I'm assuming that's what it came from. Anyway.
Yes. it's a big asparagus show.
Yeah, that's it.
Someone else is in there. I got to note this. Amongst the fans, Kofi has a wonderful reputation as one of the nicest superstars in WWE history. Is he playing with fire when it comes to ruining that reputation by his actions on Up, Up, Down, Down? We're talking about the cockiness and clearly the inability to be anything but a sore loser when it happens.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, I think it's a good reminder, too. Sometimes you put people on these pedestals and you think that they're above reproach. And it really, it's a massive hole in his game as a human being because he's a terrible sport. This man is, like I said, usually one of the most gracious, kind human beings you'll ever meet. But you play him in a game of any sort, and you see just the nastiness come out of him. You see a different side of him. You see him unravel, honestly. And it's a little sad to see.
I think it kind of goes back to what I was saying about E being a big backstage politicker.
More lies.
Everybody, I think Kofi might be wrestling's best kept secret, where everybody thinks he's this nice guy. I think the real him comes out in Up, Up, Down, Down a lot. I've seen a lot of stuff. When that red light goes on, yeah, he's nice. But when it turns off, the real Kofi comes out.
I like feisty Kofi.
And you know, I don't know about him.
I really don't. Yeah. Thank you for your honesty. And E, thank you for your honesty. I thought I might have been getting in trouble like I have done for the last 3 years in this place with you guys. But I appreciate that you felt that.
No, you and I, we made amends.
We have.
We're cool. And I think your daughter said I could move into your home.
Oh.
She did. Penny Camp yeah. did.
Did you politic him out of his house?
Yeah, I said,
I got a whole room. You got
that
it.
That makes sense to me.
It's yours. Breeze, I want to catch some folks up here on the left-right title situation. Just a summary of what's going on. Shayna, let's roll the footage.
What? Bye.
What? No, Breeze.
Oh, with the throw? Her bread and butter?
No!
Oh!
No!
Is it? I think. No!
Oh.
Finish it!
Oh!
You're out!
No.
Excuse me.
No.
No. Excuse me.
No.
Pardon me.
No.
Coming through.
No.
Coming through.
No. No. No.
I'll move that.
No. No.
Excuse me.
No. No.
No.
No.
How are you?
No.
What do you?
No.
Yeah. Maybe. Maybe not.
Okay. All right. Without your bias for a second, I'm going to try and I have been provided the history there of what we just saw.
Maybe, maybe.
So you I'll won verify. The title.
Yeah.
You refused to give it back to Woods.
That was not it.
It became a vacant title. This is what I'm just being provided.
Definitely
this is,
not.
This is I'm not in that wrestling arts and sciences yep. conversation. Yep. Ricochet won it in the tournament.
Allegedly.
Shayna got her revenge and won it. And then you came out as we saw there and immediately laid claim to the title.
Sure.
I'm giving you the floor. Why are you the real champ? Well, why is this not a Shawn Michaels Razor WrestleMania 10 situation?
So here's the thing. Here's the thing. Like you said before, I won. I won the up, up, down, down title.
You did.
Unprecedented run. Unprecedented E.
Seven title defenses.
Insane.
Nobody.
Insane. Unfortunately, I lost it. But in the process, I had turned it into the left, right title. Mm-hmm. It just looks good. It just felt right. You know what I mean? But I lost it. I immediately won the left-right title back. And I never lost it. I never lost it. You brought up my win streak of 1-0.
That's true.
I never lost it.
Oh, that's true.
I never lost this. So they put an interim champion.
Interim champions are crap.
That's right.
Awful.
That's right. So they had, you know, again, if in those clips you notice, I wasn't in them. You know where I was? You know where I was? I was back at my house with the left-right title. That's where I was. So a bunch of stuff happened.
Is it clear for you now?
It's for everybody else.
The history you got was very
up, up, down,
skewed.
Down. Offices are right down the hall. This is what they gave me. Yeah. Clearly, it's disputed, but I'm glad
we
gave you the
form.
Well,
upper management.
Clearing that up for all of us.
Well,
you are the real champion here
thank you.
In,
thank
in the
you.
Bump studio. So listen, guys, before we do bring on our next guest, we want to talk to you about something else that's near and dear to your heart, Big E, and that's Netspend. We want to remind everyone that this segment of The Bump is being presented by the WWE Netspend prepaid MasterCard. Scan the QR code on the screen now to order your card and carry your favorite WWE superstars in your wallet. Let's see what happened when Big E and Bianca Belair got their Netspend cards.
What is that?
My new WWE Netspend prepaid MasterCard.
No. That's
my Big E. By using my cashback rewards, it costs me practically nothing. You can also get paid up to 2 days faster with direct deposit, so you can get
a new chandelier for my house. And because it's not a credit card, I don't have any interest payments.
And with no cost to activate or credit check required, I have another way to make pancakes. And because it's accepted everywhere debit MasterCard is accepted,
I can get a hot tub.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, like I said, you can scan that QR code right there that you see on the screen to order your card and carry your favorite WWE superstars in your wallet. And as you can see, we have some of these cards here in the studio. And Big E, you're holding yours right now. How cool is it to have a card like this? And what are some of the advantages to Netspend? Two?
Yeah, no, it's very incredible. You know, to think that you can have your favorite superstars when you spend your money, you know, when you buy groceries or do whatever. So, yeah, Netspend has been great.
Buy some more hats and turtlenecks and sweatpants.
That's right. Yeah, you can buy clothes.
Or, like, when you're looking at me, I'd be like, oh, maybe I don't need that extra shirt, you know.
No,
like,
of course you do.
No, it's been compelling.
They are encouraging you.
I know, I need to buy
spend it all.
You're like, yes, buy it.
Maybe Randy would be like, Kayla, what are you doing? Buy this instead. I'm not saying not to buy things, but buy this instead.
Well, guys, like I said, just a reminder, this segment was brought to you by the WWE Netspend prepaid MasterCard. Bring the main event to your wallet today. And we're going to keep on popping up that graphic with this QR code throughout the rest of the show. And go get that chandelier or hot tub. Just do it.
Wow, you're shooting high, Kayla. I like that. That's good stuff.
Good suggestions, Kayla. Let's switch gears. These are really cool, though. You had a big weekend. University of Iowa, we talked about it a little before the show.
Yes, sir.
College, you know, big new kickoff. Let's take a look at some of the highlights here. Mrs. Matt Leiner, how much fun was this for you? Third time you've done it. We talked about it earlier. Such a good time, right?
A blast, man. I love college football, so just being a part of the show was incredible. But also, these are like the Paul Bunyan figures of college football when you're talking about Reggie Bush, Matt Leiner, Brady Quinn, Urban Meyer, and Rob Stone is the man. Rob, actually, a champion in WWE, a 24/7
That's
champion
right.
as well. The host of Big Noon Kickoff. But those, the whole team, everyone at Fox Sports, they're incredible. Unfortunately, the game did not go our way with Iowa, Michigan. But, man, it was so good to be back on campus. And, you know, Iowa always feels like my second home. And they show me so much love. So it was a pleasure to be on the show and to be back. and be wearing those black and gold overalls.
Also a good fit.
Yeah, I feel like that's a good look. That's a good day-to-day look. I think I can walk around.
It's a good Florida look.
Right.
Well, listen, you know, speaking of, you know, college athletes, we're about to bring on two gentlemen who know all about being a collegiate superstar. Let's please welcome on the Creed brothers.
Yeah.
How's it going, guys?
What's up, guys?
Thank you guys for having us on. We appreciate it.
Of course. Speaking of live, we're gonna dive into throughout this little interview. But first of all, how are you guys doing this morning or this afternoon?
Yeah, doing good. You know, woke up, got after it this morning, feeling accomplished for the day. Got a couple more things to do and to get out of the way later on tonight, but feeling good so far. How about you guys?
Great.
Well,
thank you.
Last night, Julius made very quick work of Duke Hudson, but it was post-match. That caught everyone's eye. You've had to deal with Damon Kemp quite a bit lately. And following your win, which we're seeing here over Duke Hudson, very impressive as you took care of business. Singles, by the way, got to note that there. You guys have been dominant as a tag team, but after the match, of course, this went down with Damon Kemp because we know what's gone on with Brutus, and then you finally had to address it because we know it's coming down at Halloween Havoc coming up soon.
Julius, you might be your brother's keeper, but he is my matter of fact, I am so confident that if you do manage to beat me at Halloween Havoc, I'll give Brutus another match. When I beat you, you are not gone from NXT. Your brother is.
You like stipulations, huh? Well, Halloween Havoc, it's you versus me in an ambulance match.
An ambulance match, huh? Sounds good. And oh, tell Roddy to make room for you.
Hey, you call for me, I answer on the first ring. Damon Kemp, get your together. I'm waiting for you.
And it is official, coming up at Halloween Havoc. Julius, you will take on Damon Kemp in an ambulance match. Brutus, I got to go to you first, though, because it's your NXT career that is now on the line and in the hands of the brother sitting next to you. What's your take on the situation right now?
Well, clearly I wasn't laughing when you showed the clip, so you can see who I favor in this one. You know, I have a lot of respect, and I put everything into what Julius has done. I'm not ever so confident in what Damon has done. So, therefore, to sit here and tell you I'm worried, I'd be lying. I know that Julius is going to come out. He's going to do what he's always done. He's a winner. He prospers through anything. He's fought a hell of a way out to get here to where he is. And I'll be damned if someone like Damon Kemp comes in his way and tries to take him out, including me. It just isn't going to happen. He may have lost previously to learn and get better, and I'll tell you, he's the best he's ever been right now.
Julius, we heard how angry you were about the situation, how fired up you were. I think you live for these moments. You get to have that moment. But I want to transition a little bit because a little bit of a happier topic. You two earned effusive praise from recent guests Kevin Owens and Johnny Gargano on a recent edition of The Bump. A little motivation for that ambulance match. Let's take a look right now.
You know, there's a lot of really good talent over there, but right now I think the Creed brothers are kind of head and shoulders above everyone else, if I'm going to be brutally honest. I really love them.
They're great.
I love to be in the ring with them, or, you know, if I ever need backup, they're probably guys I'd look to.
They're great. Fantastic.
Yeah, they had that.
Absolute freaks, man.
Yeah, they had good leadership.
They had great leadership for a while, and clearly it did them some good.
Now they're on their own.
They're thriving, and
I can just speaking from just from a one-on-one standpoint, just they also have incredible minds and are open to learn and willing to listen, and they generally want to be good at this. And that is that's a trick right there.
That
right?
goes a long way. Julius, I know you were watching when this happened. We shared some texts. Our friends and I talked about this. What does that type of endorsement from those two guys mean to you?
Yeah, I don't even know if you could really put it into words. So much of this business is standing on the shoulders of giants, and those are two guys that really have made the business what it is today. So to hear that coming from them, you know, I like to think of myself as a prize fighter, like you said, and, you know, Kevin Owens is the prize fighter. And then to hear it from Johnny, being two Ohio guys, he's also an Ohio guy, you know, that one hits close to home also. So it means the world. It means, you know, a lot of the work that we've done has been validated.
It makes us happy, but it also makes us a little bit hungrier too, because we've got a lot more to prove now. I made a post back when I was in college, before I kind of had my big ascension. And it was basically talking about how when people don't believe in you, it adds a chip to your shoulder and you do a lot to prove them wrong. But an even stronger thing is when people believe in you and you can't let them down, you'll work even that much harder for them. So, you know, whether it's Brutus having my back going into this ambulance match, or, you know, Kevin Owens and Johnny Gargano, you know, praising us, it's going to add fuel to the fire. And we're going to come out better because of it. I truly believe that.
Yeah. Hey, I got to say something, Matt.
Yeah.
Check this out. A little nod to Kevin, right? I can recline too if I want. Right here. Right here, baby.
That is now endorsed by Kay. Oh, I got. All right. So you got the royalties going. There's also a whole sneaker thing with you. I appreciate that.
I'm more of a Taxi 12 guy, but Taxi. Matt, we share that. We're sneakerheads.
All right, so there you go. We got that. But Kayla, obviously, these guys have been involved a lot lately.
Yeah, you know, keeping things on a positive note, it's very clear that you guys have garnered a really great reputation, rightfully so, with your fellow WWE superstars. And we know, Julius, the two of you, along with Ivy Nile, took part in the WWE tryout in Nashville during SummerSlam week. I think you were around too. What was an experience as, you know, being a representative of WWE?
It's so funny how things in this business come full circle. A lot of the guys that we grew up watching, we're getting the opportunity to learn from and work with now. It felt not very long ago, because it wasn't very long ago, we were going through the tryout ourselves. So it was a full circle moment to be out there, you know, trying to help other people get their foot in the door to be able to chase their childhood dreams. You know, and then on top of it, you had Big E there. You're getting to pick his brain. You're getting to pick Seth Rollins' brain. You know, Triple H was there. And we're just trying to, you know, do our part to pay it back like so many people have done for us. So, man, it was a surreal experience. It was kind of overwhelming at first. Those first couple days or first couple of sessions, you're like, how are you ever going to be able to differentiate between all these people? Like, everybody's kind of the same. But over the course of that tryout, you do see who wants it. You do see who's passionate about this, who did their homework coming in. And that's validating in a lot of ways, because when you do feel this passionate about performing and about, you know, the professional wrestling industry and specifically WWE like we do, you realize that those things do get noticed, that those things do matter, and that those people went out in the end. So it was a full circle moment, but it was also validating in a lot of ways. It was a fun, fun time.
And E, when you were seeing these guys now go from 2 years ago becoming part of WWE and then being part of that process now, and then you have a wealth of knowledge from everything you've done there, what's it like kind of being involved with these guys and then seeing the next crop of WWE superstars?
Oh, so dope, man. I was going to say, I have to add to that effusive praise, because seeing the way that you two carried yourselves, seeing how professional you were, seeing the way you conducted drills, man, I was already a fan of what you do in the ring, but my fandom took another level just the brief time I was able to spend around you in Nashville. So, man, I'm just really proud of you guys for how hard you've worked, to see how far you've gone in such a short amount of time as well. And you're so unique, you stand out. So, man, I'm such a big fan. And it was really a pleasure to meet you guys in Nashville and to see, like, you up close and personal, man. You know, whatever you guys want to do in this business, in this industry, it's all up for grabs for you guys. You got all the talent in the world, for real.
Oh, that's awesome. Well, listen, you know,
man, that's goosebumps right there. That means everything. Yeah, thank you very much.
And, you know, for all of you being big college athletes, you know, how important is it that there are established NIL programs? Biggie, I know that's something that means a lot to you.
Yeah, it's huge, man. I think, you know, we were college athletes at one point, and I think for us, you know, playing a college sport is incredible and you spend so much of your time doing it. But I think I really didn't get to learn the value of separating myself as a brand of, you know, I didn't get to really profit off of my name, image, and likeness. And I'm so glad that now college athletes have that ability now with what WWE is doing, with the Next in Line, and the way we're branding our NIL stuff, I think is really great. So now we have an opportunity with college athletes to say, hey, we hope you all go pro and make a ton of money. But if not, because that's not a reality for everyone, here's an opportunity now to get in the system with WWE, to understand that there's a pipeline, that there is an opportunity. You know, for me, I was 23 years old. I was done playing college football. I didn't know what was next. And then this opportunity came up for me, and it completely changed my life. So to be able to find other young athletes who are trying to figure it out, or who really might love doing this and want to give it a shot, or who have no idea at all. Like, you know, I think we spend so much time, and rightfully so, emphasizing the people who have always loved this. And I think that's truly incredible. But there are people like me, too, who were fans as a kid, but like I didn't always dream of doing this. And, you know, getting that opportunity can really open so many doors and you can find so much great talent. So I love what we're doing with NIL. I love the opportunity for college athletes to get into WWE, hopefully, and do incredible things, man. And we have so many talent who've just come from the independent scene, but you also look back at some of the biggest names like Roman playing football at Georgia Tech. And I think Steve Austin played at North Texas. There's so many of these athletes who I think can really add a lot to what we're doing in the company.
And you're in that conversation as well. Don't sell yourself short.
And Julius and Brutus, piggybacking off of what he just said there, such a big part of being a young up-and-coming athlete is managing expectations. Just in this conversation alone, you got effusive praise from E. We saw it from Gargano and Kevin. We have some tweets here. We have one from Corey Graves saying, I have a feeling that the Creed brothers are going to be big stars sooner than later. WWE Universe, I could have pulled literally thousands of tweets like this one here saying, bro, the Creed brothers are stars. How do you two go about managing those expectations? Because the praise and the goosebump moments are amazing. Does it add pressure? How do you two go about it, especially with other young athletes possibly listening?
Well, we like pressure, but yeah, if you want to talk about it.
Pressure's a privilege. You know, that means that something's expected out of you. And a conversation I just recently had was when those lights are on and it's the opportunity to shine bright, to perform on the highest stage, we deliver. But we deliver because of all the work that we did in the dark. And when you get that praise and when you get those moments, it makes you push a little bit more. You look at all the doors that have been opened for us, all the opportunities, everything, you know, God has done for us. The only thing you have to do is work hard every day and give all you got. Like, that's not too bad. So, you know, the praise is great. We love the praise. We're trying to build off of it and continue to keep going, you know. Work hard, dream big, and stay humble is kind of the motto around here. So we love the praise, but we're not going to let it, you know, push us onto the side of arrogance. Hopefully it just, you know, fuels the confidence. We're going to continue to work hard. And, you know, hopefully when we do climb that mountain, we're able to reach back and offer a helping hand to whoever comes next. But, awesome. You know, Diamond Mine's Diamond Mine for a reason. There is pressure. Every time we go out there, I can tell you that nobody expects more out of us than we expect out of ourselves. You know, I'm my own biggest fan. I'm my own biggest critic. I know that Brutus feels the same way. We've run as a tag team this entire time, but, you know, that's by design. We, you know, you want to talk about singles runs. We performed in a sport where you're out there by yourself. You're under that light by yourself. You don't have a, you know, a goalie to save you if they get past you. You don't have a, you know, a safety to make that tackle. It's just you out there, and everything falls on your shoulders. And this was the first opportunity we had in our lives to actually be out there together and to share something together and to accomplish something, you know, out there together at the same exact time. And that was a really, really special thing. We weren't team sport guys really growing up, sure. You know, we're wrestlers through and through. Well, and because of that, you know, I think we will have success when it comes time to run singles, but I think we'll also be able to handle the pressure because we've done this our whole lives. We weren't born into the business. You know, we're not second generation guys. We weren't, you know, brought up in the business, but I do believe, like, you know, everything we've done in our lives is culminating in this business right now. And this is what we were put here to do.
We agree with you. We're glad you're here. We're looking forward to seeing what else you do. Thank you for joining us, gentlemen. We'll see you soon.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate y'all.
All right, hey, thank you, guys. I appreciate every opportunity you guys give us. Thank you.
Got it.
Have a good one.
Oh, they're great. Well, guys, before we get into the last part of our show here, we do want to show off some new exciting items on WWE Shop all October. We're celebrating the 25th anniversary of Kane in WWE. In fact, today is the anniversary. Bad blood in your house. It was October 5th, 97. And to celebrate, let's get out some of these items. Ryan, what do you got over there?
Well, Kayla, thanks for asking. We got a bunch of cool Kane masks. There's this one. It's a bit more plastic. This one's a bit of a different thing. They're great for Halloween. And then if you want to, you know, possibly accessorize, if you will, we got this Kane shirt. Which is really cool. Kayla, you were really fancying it before the show. We got that Kane shirt. There's a lot of cool Kane merch. But speaking of cool Kane merch, Matthew Campbell.
The guys over here have a new championship title. And let's take a look. If you want to take it out here, guys, you see the very cool display case. There it is. Let's talk about this Kane title, because the title strap features the likeness of Kane's iconic red and black outfit worn on his debut 25 years ago, October 5th, 1997, at Bad Blood in Your House, and worn throughout the Attitude Era. Design elements include homages to the laces featured on his pants, as well as golden versions of the rivets worn on his ring, gear, glove, wristband, and belt. to complete the outfit. The custom shape behind the center plate is inspired by his classic mask worn during these early years. And the reverse side of the title features
around.
A custom printed pattern with Kane's original mask and Red Monster, a nickname he was known out throughout his career. The metal plates are inspired by the 1998 version of the WWE Championship, which only Kane and Stone Cold Steve Austin had the privilege of winning. The center plate on this version features red and black coloring, customized to be uniform with Kane's iconic outfits throughout the years. And the strap also features an appearance by the classic version of the Big Red Machine himself, with fully custom metal Kane end cap as a final touch. The signature series title. Go to WWE Shop and get your exclusive Kane title for $499.99.
Got it. All right, guys. We got one more thing we want to do. We know how much you two, or how much you love wheels and Wheel of Fortunes. Play a little game with this wheel that we have behind
us. It's the Wheel of Weird, by the way.
Whatever number it lands on, we're going to show you a random clip from WWE history, and you guys are going to give us your Breeze and Efied breakdown commentary of that clip. So you want to go ahead and spin that?
You going to spin it?
Spin the wheel.
Oh my God.
Also, check out my eBay for this one.
No, it's on WWE Shop.
Yeah, sure. Right.
What's the number? What a spin here with 4 minutes to go on the show.
Short of a spin.
It is number four. Show me clip number four. Guys, we need your thoughts on this. This is Ultimate Warrior having some issues at the hands of Papa Shango.
This messed up my childhood a little bit.
Me too.
I remember. Like, I didn't even want to. This man vomiting over here. Because I was really spooked. I really thought like he could do voodoo.
Yeah, legit.
Yeah.
He did.
Right.
He did.
What's his favorite wrestler?
Ooh.
Yeah,
Shango. Right. Love Shango.
And Wade Barrett. Yeah. Wade wants him at Royal Rumble.
Right. And remember 1 year that he actually. It wasn't Shango. He came out as. Was it Godfather?
Godfather.
Right, do we have time for one more?
One more.
Oh, God.
Spin it!
Two more.
Maybe not as. Yeah.
There we go.
Nice medium spin.
Just a little spin.
Ooh, don't be number four, and we should be okay.
Go back to four.
Okay, how dare you? 18.
What's 18?
Oh no.
Boogeyman.
What are you doing?
Oh, I was eating the thing off her face.
You love horror though. You love horror.
I know, but I know him.
He ate the thing off her face.
He did. That was cool.
Oh gosh, that's disgusting.
Random fact, actually, Boogeyman and I had the same college defensive line coach.
Oh,
and look where it sent you guys.
Right? We just different colleges. Yeah, it was a small college. Yeah, I know it has nothing to do with the clip, really.
That's good to know.
Right.
Another one.
That was maybe the most famous Piper's pick. Nine. We haven't hit that one. What's great spinning? What's nine?
That's a good spin.
Give me nine.
Great way to end. Obviously, we all love Titus. That being said, we don't want to. But I was in the ring for this, and I remember the confusion because I was like, all right, Titus is coming. I see him, and then he just wasn't there. He just was gone, and it was this weird silence, and we're all just kind of looking around and waiting, and he just wasn't there. And then I started hearing like a smattering of like cackles. And then they started replaying it to death.
Oh yeah.
But here's the thing we always talk about, man. Like, we all laugh at this now, but usually there's like a center, like a truss.
Yeah. You don't know what's under that apron.
Right. And like, that could have been really bad. Yeah. I think he just missed it.
Somehow.
So thankfully, like, he wasn't hurt. It ended up being very comedic. But I remember, I think by the time we landed back in the States, I think they already had a
there was already shirt out. There was an official shirt.
He knows the money.
He does.
You might have learned that from him a little
bit. Yeah, he knows how to get to the money. That he does.
Listen,
what a clip.
Well, we got about a minute left on the show. So happy you guys could join us. Any final words you want to say to those who are watching?
What, me?
Say something.
What are we doing on your TikTok? I thought you were getting us paid here.
Yeah, hit my TikTok. And
what is your TikTok?
It's just a Tor Ewan. That's my government name.
Right.
Yeah, okay. Tor Ewan. Right.
The full name.
That's it, yes. But for all you beautiful people out there, love on each other. You know what I mean?
I'm
here to send a message of love and zen. You know what I mean? I'm thankful now in my older years.
Get your hands off me.
Stop. In my older years, I'm very thankful for the beautiful friendships that I have. And it is a pleasure to make all of you laugh. For everyone who has supported me, everyone who's asked about my neck, thank you so much. I am doing well. Life is good. I've really just been incredibly blessed. It's been a great year for me. So don't worry about your boy. I'm doing well.
Yes.
And hug your friends. Hug the people you love.
What a way to
end it. Love is beautiful.
And that's what you need. Everyone, again, Extreme Rules this Saturday in Philadelphia. We will be there live on the ground, of course, with interviews and talking about everything going on. Ryan will be here. And also, don't forget, Comic-Con, up, down, down. Nerds booth. Get the shirt.
Scribblin'.
Come see us. New York Comic Con.
Bring everything.
Tomorrow.
Bring everything.
Yeah.
Lots of Scribblin'.
We'll be there. Woods
hey,
too.
Would you write for extra money, Link?
Okay. Well,
yeah.
You would, right?
Yeah, I got you.
Go to the warehouse. Go look for it. It might be up there. I heard the names there.
Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you on Saturday.
Oh, yeah. Easy. Easy.
You guys like lay cool with the chair titles?